Hello and welcome back everyone. So my another set of questions is like from 21 to 50. These are just a medium log. You can just go through them. There's no need to cover all these. You can read and better understand than me. So what is a callback hell and how we can avoid them, right? So in Node.js, what are the basic ways of writing asynchronous code? Either using the callback or either using timer functions like set timeout, all these. Otherwise, when we write the code with the event loop, callback, then there may be cases that we are nesting with the callbacks, and that's not the right approach. And it can create a callback hell kind of a situation, zigzag, right? The staircase of functions. So we can avoid them with the help of promises. Now every library is available with the help of a promisified version of each library is available. Or you can use a generator, so you can use async await, or using all these things, you can avoid the nested callback. Or whatever the nested callback you are writing, write them as a plain functions. One function taking another argument. So callback can also be solved with the simple plain functions. Okay. So or you can what you can do, you can promisify the functions like this. So promisify is a library. Promisify is available in the util, and what you can do, you can promisify the function like fs.read file. This is the callback based version available. We can promisify this read file async, and now we are doing it with the promises, right? The callback, we converted that into the promise based implementation. What are the promises and how to use promises for simple AJAX call for a multiple AJAX call? Okay, that is simple, right? So promise, we can use a promise chaining where we are actually passing the output of single promise to the second promise to the third promise. There we can use a multiple promises, and here we can deal with the multiple calls, or promise.all if you have heard about, where we can resolve the multiple promises together. Otherwise like this, read file async, this is returning promise. I'm doing a dot then on that and I'm getting the read out of it. So promise is being used extensively in Node.js. Node.js is currently purely written in callback based, but every library is promisified and you can use the promises. Like Mongoose earlier used to be a callback based, now it is a promise based. What is a global object in Node.js and how it can be used? Okay, you heard about the window object on the browser. Similarly, there is a global object for the Node.js process running. Okay. And you can put something in the global object that is available throughout your application. Okay, so this is something global throughout your application. And this global object has your process, everything about your application like this. So in your application, we used to pass the environment and the code, right? So that is being captured in the process object, which is a part of global object. So process.env.nodeenv, it will give us the value of local. And if I do process.env.port, it will give me the port value. Okay, what are the streams? Another important aspect of the Node.js streams are being extensively used whenever we are actually reading the large chunk of data. When we don't have a small file and we see the data cannot be read, everything cannot be read at the same time. So in that case, we use streams. So you can see we are creating the stream by reading the file, and then we are creating the chunks of that read stream and then responding. So these are the events. Once we start getting the data from the stream, data event, and event, and error event. How can we have a separate config for development and production? Very easy and very good question. So we always have the config object, right? Where we put production, dev, all these environment variables, right? So globally, we can have one variable, process.env.nodeenv. Okay. This we can have a value of dev, QA, production, and all. And based on that, we can read the configuration object. Okay, so here require config config.js. So it will read this complete config, and there we are just getting only this particular environment file. Or better approach, you can use a .env. I will talk about that. .env is actually npm module. Using this, you can manage the configuration of your application. Like you just need to manage a .env, which will have a db host, db user, db password here. And what it will do, you just write this .env in your application, and then in your code, you just need to require .env.config, on the top of your server.js, and you will get all these db host, db user, db password in the process object, process.env, db host. You can get the value from as a local host. Process.env, db user, you will get the value root, because you have defined this .env inside a .env file and you have required this file. This is another thing which people use for the local development, and that is the right way of implementing it. You can have, so this is, in this you cannot separate the environments. That is the drawback. Either you need to manage the multiple .env file for each and every environment, but that's not the right way. But this is used for single configuration. But for multiple configuration, which we talked about, you can have this kind of configuration, right? And you write the get method in this, which what it is doing is, it is just giving you the config of that environment. So we have production, we have a dev, right? So what I'm doing, I'm requiring this config and passing the environment from the node.env. So I will get either production, I will either get development environment, okay? And I can use it further like Mongo URL. This is another implementation. Okay, what are the module type which Node.js currently supporting? So Node.js has a module like ESX modules, CommonJS, AMD, UMD. But currently whatever we are getting from the npmjs.com, that all are CommonJS modules. But Node.js will support the ESM modules. So ESM is something which is coming up. Node.js will start supporting the ESX modules. Right now, if you wanted to use import-export syntax in Node.js code, we need to have a Babel there, right? Because that is not currently natively supported. We either we need to use a Babel node or Babel register there. So if we want the native support, then you need to use the ESM support, ESM modules. So instead of .js, you will be writing the file .esm. And that is coming. It's coming. It's part of Node.js 10. What are the differences between the promises, callback, async, await? You better know this. Otherwise, you can just go through this whole content. It is covering each and everything. What is event loop? Is it part of V8 runtime engine or available on the browser? The event loop is provided by libuv library. It's not part of your V8 runtime engine. That's the mistake everybody do. Okay. What will be the state of Node.js process when the event loop is empty? Okay. Node.js is a command line process, and if there is nothing in the event loop or call stack, it will exit directly. So until unless you are running some HTTP server or you are doing some asynchronous task, Node.js process will keep running. Once the task is completed, it will exit. So you see, when you write node index.js and if it is doing some calculation, it will process that and it will exit. But when you create HTTP server, it's up and running, right? Because HTTP server makes your event loop always busy. It is expecting that some request will come sometimes, so it will keep that event loop busy. In that case, your application is up and running, but if you are writing some synchronous or asynchronous code which will over in few seconds, then the Node.js will exit. Okay, what is the call stack, and it is part of V8 runtime engine? Yes, call stack, where we are talking about the stack and heap stack, is using LIFO pattern, last in, first out, and the heap which is managing the memory. Right, so here I'm talking about the call stack, where one function is calling another function is calling another function, then that the stack is being generated, then stack will be popping the last in first out and processing one by one. Okay, that's it. Thanks everybody.